Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We are watching the organized degeneration and collapse of the human community as it has existed for thousands of years upon this small planet. And the social engineers believe they have a method to their madness, that they're going to channel the collapse of society and even augment it so that they can consolidate control. But it's clear that they are not escaping the blowback from their intensification of worldwide problems. We're going to be live here for the next 3 hours on this live Monday edition. When Max Keiser was in studio with us a week and a half ago in London, there in my hotel room from our makeshift studio, he said, see, this is the collapse that I was talking about, but it's coming a month and a half after I said it would. He said late April, now it's mid-June. And he said that in early June. In fact, the day Bilderberg kicked off, June 6th. And then I was sitting there for about an hour this morning watching CNBC just to see what they were telegraphing to the public. They always tell you things a long time after it's basically already been set up. And they were saying that the Fed will slowly start cutting off QE infinity. So I guess that takes the infinity out of it. And that's why the stock market's down the last few weeks and why the dollar and other currencies have been dropping. And inflation is marked everywhere. I don't care what fake inflation numbers they put out in the newspaper. We all know inflation's up everywhere. And so we're going to be breaking that down with Max Keiser when he joins us from London. That's where he lives in the second hour. In the meantime, here's some of the other headlines up on Infowars.com. Journalist, TSA shamed my teenage daughter. That's the plan. Break your will. Train you that you're a slave. Set the precedent. Russian tycoon predicts immortality within 25 years. That's what they're going for. Doesn't mean they're going to get it. 14-year-old faces year in jail over pro-gun t-shirt. They say the shirt is terroristic threat. It's an NRA, defend your rights, is what the shirt says. How evil, how un-American then to defend your rights. The next NSA snooping shoe to drop, pre-crime, artificial intelligence. I've been telling you that for 15 years. Now that's mainstream news. In fact, I have a case of a guy on Twitter, well-known writer, said nothing threatening to Obama. Secret Service came, intimidated him into signing a release to get his mental records. And the guy went along with it. I'm going to get him on the show. Show up here and try to make me sign something, and you're going to be told to go to North Korea, which might as well be hell. So I know you're trying to make it hell, but we're trying as best we can to stop that. I mean, I really care about the future. I really care about my children. I really care about your children. California has put it on the books. They can have 1,000 times the Roundup Ready chemical, glyphosate, in your water. You understand at 1/1,000th of that level, it massively increases cancer across the board in major studies. We're going to be getting to that. Now just think about it. They're killing us. And all the yuppies will do is laugh about it, even as they're dying. It's like, it's fun. It's fun. It's fun. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen, with the latest on the establishment's plunging poll numbers, the economy, what's happening with Saudi Arabia, giving missiles to Al-Qaeda, and more. Ladies and gentlemen, It is Monday, the 17th day of June 2013. And this is just out via the London Guardian. Snowden, the truth is coming, and the government can't even stop it by murdering me. Avoiding a specific question on the scope of documents he obtained about the National Security Agency's surveillance program, former NSA contractor Edward Snowden suggested Monday that he believes the federal government wants to either jail him or murder him. Well, yeah, that's been in the news that they've been bragging about killing him, because it's not the U.S. government. It is a foreign mafia. Yeah, put that back up on screen for me. Business Insider is also reporting that. He's been doing a live chat with a bunch of newspapers for the last 2 hours and answering their questions. So we'll be going over more of that today. Also, Supreme Court strikes down Arizona voting rules, saying you don't have to show an ID that you're a U.S. citizen. You don't have to show a driver's license, nothing. So the government spies on everything you do, but when you go to vote, you don't have to show any ID that you're even who you say you are. And the Democratic Party particularly has been caught in all 50 states engaged in retail voter fraud. People voting over and over again, illegals voting. If I went to Mexico and wanted to go vote in their election, they would want to see my driver's license or consular matriculum. You know, that's my whole thing about this amnesty. We talk about Mexico because that's about 80% of the people that are coming here. I can't go to Mexico with my wife pregnant, walk in, have the baby, have it all paid for, and my kid is a citizen. If I'm caught illegally in Mexico, I'm going to spend 6 months hard labor. That's on record. Now, I'm not saying do that to illegal aliens here, but this sense of hospitality in America is what's going to destroy us. And the sense of groveling to government as well. Groveling to uniforms, groveling to fake authority. And that's why they're putting code enforcers and bureaucrats in uniforms now, because the average American falls on their knees. I might do a test where I'd dress up like a king and walk around the street and tell people to bow. They probably will. I know if I put on a third world dictator uniform, they would. And it's comical when some militia person dresses up in a general outfit. Remember, some of the Republic of Texas, not the whole Republic of Texas, but some of them, you know, would go have rallies. There'd be like 10 guys. They were all generals. One guy's an admiral because he's got a bass boat. They'd have like, you know, 4 stars on their shoulder in an army uniform redone, an army dress uniform. And one guy would have a Marine dress uniform. And they would announce, I am the president, because out at our, you know, farm, my cousins voted me in as the president of the Republic of Texas. Sam Houston got voted in an election to be the president after he won the war, guys. You don't just skip all that and become president. And all he did was wear an insignia on his hat as the head of the Texas forces. And government's the same way. The Queen of England dressed up in a clown suit with a big crown is utterly ridiculous. Just like you look at some native in Africa or Latin America today, down in Brazil, you know, wearing a big headdress and everyone's bowing down to them and they're real proud to the explorers and expect you to bow down because they've got a shrunken head hanging around their neck and a big feather headdress. Or if you go to New Guinea or something and visit the headhunters there, it's comical if you're an anthropologist there visiting with them. And it's comical. The police uniforms, the red carpets, the jumbo jets, the Air Force One, and thousands of other aircraft used by the federal government as generals and congresspeople fly around like royalty. It is a giant corrupt group of con artists and criminals festooning themselves in dark suits, festooning themselves in red carpets and award ceremonies and titles, all with a bunch of inch deep, mile wide, narcissist, totally unhappy, all dishonorable, completely cowardly, vapid, and not even alive. And that's why if you're watching me on TV today, not just listening on the radio, radio listeners can go to infowars.com/show. We now offer the daytime radio show for everybody as a service against the New World Order at infowars.com/show. The archives of all the films, the high-def version of the show, the nightly news, everything else is on prisonplanet.tv. But if you go there, you'll notice that I am wearing a black sports jacket and a camouflage dress shirt. And I did that just to illustrate this point today. That everybody looks at the surface of things. Does someone have a short haircut? Is someone thin? Does someone have erect posture? Are they wearing a nice jacket? Is the cut of the jacket well done? The tailoring? Does the shirt look clean and properly starched? Is the tie well appointed? And then off of that, and they've done criminology studies where women will get in the car with a sharp-dressed man, even though he's a serial killer, or the person is doing a criminology test playing the part of a serial killer. But if you put a billionaire in a dirty T-shirt and shorts, no one will get in the car with him. And as a society, we have gotten in the car with predatory, out-of-control parasites who don't just not care about us, they hate us. And I'm going to get into some of that today to understand why we've gotten to this point. And so now on the video of this, it'll undoubtedly get posted on YouTube and Daily Motion and everywhere, you will see the majority of the comments, even though I've explained all this, about is it good fashion taste to wear a camouflage shirt with a black sports jacket? Just like if I, guys, you dig around under my desk here. I think there's a container right there with some of my sunglasses. If I was to put sunglasses on top of it, people would all tune in and ask, why is he wearing sunglasses? See, everything is about surface. Everything is about what is on the surface, and that's how it is. That's how it is throughout history. That's cool. Don't worry about it. I just had the wild hair to wear sunglasses and kind of take the metaphor to the next level or the illustration to the next level. And then you come to the realization, these aren't mine. Who knows if they fit? Kind of like Agent Smith Matrix classes. You come to the realization that that's what people are into. And they want the surface. They want the illusion over the reality. They've been trained, especially by television, that that's all that matters. And that's something that the most gutter rock and roll stars or hip-hop rap people get. Have a bunch of women in bikinis jumping around in front of a mansion at a pool, wear a bunch of gold around your neck, wear a crown on your head, and everyone will bow down to you. And that's actually true. The police will bow down to you. The bureaucrats will bow down to you. The whole culture will bow down to you because you're saying, I'm somebody. And within that lie, they can sell you tyranny. And more than 80 years ago, Edward Bernays, head of the Department of War, Psychological Warfare Division, and a top consultant to all of the Fortune top 100 companies at the time. He came out and said, you know, we've got to take burgeoning Hollywood and we've got to merge it. He said this in the 30s. We've got to merge it with red carpet events with politicians to make them celebrities and to shift debate away from issues and facts to how someone's suit or tie looks. And they did that. And this had gone on before for thousands of years. I mean, the Rough Riders met down at the Menger Hotel in San Antonio, Teddy Roosevelt, and they said, we'll get photographers and illustrators out there, and we've got Hearst Publishing behind us, the big newspaper chain owned by a big robber baron, coal robber baron, William Randolph Hearst, and we'll ride up San Juan Hill. There'll be no one there fighting us. And then we'll report atrocities like babies in incubators and Gaddafi raping women with Viagra. It doesn't matter if it's not true. And we will announce that we have defeated the Spanish, and we'll have some other events, blowing up the Maine, a false flag in 1898, and then we'll take the entire Pacific Ocean from the Spanish. And so that's just how things are done. But you've got a general public not even aware that that's going on. And I guess we're all slaves to it, because I guess I do wear a sports jacket. I'm building a more fancy studio, all because that will get the sheeple to pay more attention. And then maybe from that platform, I can get them out of their trance. Because let me explain to you what's really going on past all the hype and all the glitter and all the glamour. You are being murdered slowly, and I'm going to tell you about that when we come back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the worldwide radio transmission, simulcast with a free podcast and audio feeds and all the free iPhone and Droid apps at Infowars.com/show, where you can also see me wearing Jim Jones sunglasses. These are not mine. One of the crew loaned them to me so that I could do the illustration of people have been trained to only look on the surface. Now, in the old days, in every major culture, it wasn't just the surface unless it was the beauty of a woman. Even if a man was big and strong, it wasn't really respected on the surface until the person was proven. Everything was about proven, proven quality. Proven loyalty, proven, see, and still today the successful don't look on the surface. The successful look on what's proven. The losers look on what's glitzy and glamorous and the flavor of the day. And that's what's going to separate in this society the winners from the losers. And I want you to win. I want you to be successful. I believe in a win-win. The problem is the globalists are engineering a society where that's not the case. They would rather have a monopoly of control. And they would rather have you just be spectators who look on the surface, because if you stop looking on the surface, you'll find out what's going on behind the mask. And then you might actually be a contender in the marketplace, and the monopoly men don't want that. Now, I'm going to cover this later, after we cover economic news with Max Keiser, and ask him why he thinks this is happening. But let me just get a little bit into this now, then I'll get into the military, economic, and huge NSA and Supreme Court rulings where the illegals can all vote. I mean, that's the plan. They're going to get our guns. If I could turn the illegals into pro-gun, pro-liberty people, quite frankly, I think we can handle 30 million people. We can't, folks. It's going to be over. Socialism at the grassroots, fascism on top, all our guns are going to be taken, and the state's going to take most of our kids. There's going to be a civil war in the country, and they're going to racially brand it, and it's very, very sad. And the globalists will destroy this country one way or another. And what was the old saying? It's easier to burn down a barn than to build one. The globalists love to wreck things because it's so much easier, and they've created cosmology, or kind of a universal world construct. And this is just the news from today and yesterday, a very small portion of it that I'd like to show TV viewers. Radio listeners can just search engine this. You can find it. California allows up to 1,000 times more glyphosate in drinking water than needed. Then it links to major scientific studies. That a fraction of what they allow in the water and what they say is safe is absolutely connected to sexual cancers, especially female cancers, ovarian and breast. And of course, we lead the world in breast cancer, and we lead the world in glyphosate usage. The study published in Food and Chemical Toxicology is entitled Glyphosate Induces Human Breast Cancer Cells Growth Via Estrogen Receptors. Hey, don't get rid of Roundup. Just cut your breast off, man. Come on. I mean, don't tell Angelina Jolie why there's a 3,000+% breast cancer increase in the U.S., something like 2,500 in Canada. And I'm wrong. When I was in England, I learned they've gone above us. They now lead the world for major industrialized countries in breast cancer. And the U.S. and England are kind of neck and neck on who's going to take the crown. You go to countries where there's no GMO, where they're not taking a bunch of vaccines, where they don't have glyphosates. People are like, cancer? That's what 80-year-old people get sometimes? You mean you have children dying of cancer? We've never heard of that. Never heard of it here either. But hey, again, I'm a conspiracy theorist. Next, I'm going to tell you that the NSA is spying on you, like I told you 18 years ago, exactly how they were. Of course, it's in the news now. They're economically spying on you. But see, here's the rest of the story. I don't like the communists in Venezuela, but the communists there are kind of the run-of-the-mill, blue-collar type. So you've got to halfway respect them. They're not like a Chinese communist type. It's actually run by the West, by a bunch of bankers like Rockefeller on record. Venezuela considers banning baby bottle feeding, but they're bare minimum going to ban formula. Well, I mean, why not? Brains of children fed different formulas, on some cases, are 30% smaller. I mean, the CC size of the cranium inside is the same. Look this up. The brain never grows. You'd think what came out of mama's mammary glands is what you're supposed to have, but how about have something that's 70% sugar instead of 20% sugar like it's supposed to be and doesn't have the protein fat? But we all know low fat's good for you, so. I mean, no wonder the public's a bunch of zombies. Fluoride poisons. I mean, I always say to people that call them that are really dumb, did your mother not breastfeed you? And they always get mad and go, no, she didn't. And I feel sorry for these people. These are lobotomized zombies. I mean, I can't believe they can even tie their shoelaces. Monday through Friday, 12 noon to 3 p.m. Eastern, we're here live. Thank you so much for joining us. The news websites are Infowars.com and Prisonplanet.com. You know, I saw an article where Ben and Jerry's on the subject of breast milk being healthier for children. No kidding. They've been toying with the idea of having human breast milk flavored ice cream. And then you've got a trendy company I saw last week in the news here in Austin that has breast milk in their lollipops. So I guess they've got women who are pumping milk and doing that to make a bunch of money off a specialty market for yuppies. But then babies whose brains are designed, whether it's a cow, then that milk's designed for a calf. Or if it's a chimpanzee, its milk is designed for a chimpanzee. And it's almost become a conspiracy theory that you shouldn't breastfeed your children. And they, oh, women, go to work, you know, the first few months and just give your child this formula. They've had all these formula scandals around the world where the formula is so bad, children die en masse. And so then they reformulate it to where it only brain damages the children. And I'm not trying to be mean about this, making fun of people. It's a very sad culture, very sick. If you can't breastfeed your children at least the first 6 months, something's wrong with you. Me, I was breastfed till I was 18 months old, and my mother always tells a story of I walked up to her in Target, and I said, hey, Mama, I want to eat right now. I used another choice word, and she said, that is it. You are weaned officially. But you know, in third world countries where the kids would starve, you know, sometimes it goes longer, and it's a natural thing. And they try to make it dirty. They try to make it bad. This is what mammals do. I know that's a conspiracy theory for some people out there. You know, money doesn't grow on trees, neither does mother's milk. And I had Mike Adams in here last year, and he brought several different brands of the best-selling, we should do a report on this, best-selling formula powder. And most of them were 70+% corn syrup and sugar. It'd be 45% corn syrup and then 15% high fructose corn syrup and 15% this sugar and that. I mean, unbelievable. And that's not what is in human milk. It's a lower percentage of natural sugar from your mother. It is a protein and fat that your brain's made out of. It's like they say, don't eat butter. But then all the studies show it's the hydrogenated artificial oils that are cooked that are clogging up your heart because it's not natural. It's like McDonald's. I heard on the news 10 years ago, almost ran off the road, that, well, McDonald's has been authorized to continue using silicon in their fried foods like McNuggets. And I went home and looked it up, and it turns out that most of the fried foods at fast food places have a plastic agent in them. Do you know what that does to your kidneys? See, we're living in the twilight zone. So right here, California allows up to 1,000 times more glyphosate in drinking water than needed. Venezuela considers banning baby bottle feeding. Now, again, here's something that gives you all sorts of cancer. Testicular cancer, breast cancer, because it's a toxic estrogen mimicker and totally accelerates the aging. That's why girls are going into puberty when they're 6, 7, 8 years old now. Used to be 13, 14. Boys are waiting to go into puberty till 15, 16 because they've been feminized. In fact, there's a large phenomenon now I read about where male testicles are not dropping ever because we're being hit with chemical warfare. Here's another one. Venezuela considers banning baby bottle feeding. The Venezuelan Congress is set to discuss legislation next week that would prohibit bottle feeding of infants in an attempt to encourage breastfeeding and reduce the use of baby formula. And it says that the head of the Venezuelan ruling Socialist Party said the proposal would prohibit all types of baby bottles as a way to improve children's health. Oh, I hate to agree with socialists, but I tell you. And the nanny state has no right to do stuff like that. I guess it is really child abuse, though. I guess they do in a way. But it just shows how that's its own rogue, weird socialist state down there. That's why they want to bring it down. If you're the communist state of China murdering political dissidents and giant Foxconn, you know, factories with humans committing suicide mass, that's okay. But if you want to see a real socialist country would actually want a bunch of worker bees and wouldn't want the cost of brain damaged dumb people everywhere. But a eugenics program would. America was the enemy, folks, because of our liberties. So they put fluoride in our water that lowers IQ on average 20 points, increases cancer. Look it up. Harvard studies. Magic word, Harvard. 60 years of formula, all of it. The public are as dumb as a box of rocks. Let's continue here. Researchers find biological evidence of Gulf War illness. And they found in the brain scans, the CAT scans, that indeed there is cell death in the tissue of the vets. This is old news, folks, but this just came out Friday. They know that the U.S. government, the Pentagon, ordered more than 200 sites, some small, some gigantic, like Kamacia. People thought nukes had gone off when they blew up these weapons caches of sarin, VX, mustard gas, you name it. And there were mushroom clouds of it right over the border from Kuwait. It rained down. 25,000-plus chemical weapons detectors went off. I watched congressional hearings in 93, 2 years after Desert Storm. And the troops, some of them that were closer, it got through their mask and killed them. But then when the detectors went off, they went, we got a problem. Are we going to admit we ordered chemical weapons blown up as if they didn't know what was going to happen? And now we're going to have to give everybody treatment for this? The answer is just tell them take their mask off. It's a false alarm. And the troops went, well, most of these detectors aren't sophisticated. They're chemical tape. You put tape all over the tanks on your uniform, and if chemical nerve agents hit it, stripes pop up. And everybody was on the news going, it turned on. My eyes are watering too. Oh, no, you didn't get hit by anything, sweetie pie. And then they had all these Marines and Army officers in wheelchairs testifying that, you know, just 6 months ago, I could still walk. It made me cry watching it. Now I can hardly talk. And the guy, was famously died a few weeks after the testimony. I think it was a Marine colonel. And thousands of them died right then. Hundreds of thousands have been sick. 50-something thousand have died total. Thousands within just a few months of it happening. And massive increases in birth defects, just like using DU, 14-fold increase in Fallujah, 7-fold increase across the board in Iraq. Our troops, same thing, 3 to 6-fold increase in deformity from the DU. Why? Because the globalists did it on purpose, folks. They invented DU. as a weapon back in 1945. In 46, they had white papers written up on it. I've had Doug Rocky, the former head of the program, all of them on. And they knew exactly what it was doing. They knew exactly what was happening. And our military was corrupt and was influenced heavily by 30,000-plus Nazis they brought over here. But they still would radiate some troops and nerve gas some troops and test and, you know, get foster kids and radiate them to death. But that was core groups of scientists. But there was enough general knowledge. That was kind of the mad scientist corps, the eugenics corps. You know, regular scientists led into the cult. And any scientist will tell you that's a good scientist, they've been offered into the cult. My dad was offered into the cult as a high schooler. He was in the science academy for the state, and a junior and a senior, and I've told the story before. And they brought him in and the other five top scorers out of hundreds and said that they brought to the university for testing all summer long and said, all right, you ready to hear the grand plan? The point is that's how you get the mad scientists to do all this. Once you have that core, you can expand your shadow government using the mad scientist. And if you look at all the different departments of energy, all these departments, they're all run by mad scientists like John P. Holdren, who writes books about how he wants to get rid of 80% of the world's population, how they're spiking your water supply, wrote the book Eco-Science. Now, the issue, I mean, this is just today's news. California allows up to 1,000 times more glyphosate in drinking water than needed. And again, by needed, then that's what they mean by what's safe, to cause breast cancer in women. That's Mike Adams' headline. Last week, a story broke that revealed glyphosate, the chemical name of Roundup herbicide, multiplies the proliferation of breast cancer cells by 500 to 1,300%, even as exposures of just a few parts per trillion. The study published in Food and Chemical Toxicology is entitled Glyphosate Induces Human Breast Cancer Cell Growth Via Estrogen Receptors. There's a whole lot more to the story, however, but to follow it, you need to understand these terms. PPM equals parts per million. Minus 6 equals numbers of parts out of a million. PPB equals parts per billion equals 10 minus 9, which is 1,000 times smaller than PPM. PPT parts per trillion equals 10 minus 12, which is 1,000 times smaller than the 1 million times smaller than PPM. And then it just goes into the fact that parts per trillion in the major study show huge increases in breast cancer, just in a breast cancer study. And now they are allowing 1,000 times what they were previously authorizing in the water. And then there's a lot more to the story. The point is it's up on Infowars.com and naturalnews.com. But here it is right here. Researchers find biological evidence of Gulf War illness. And it goes over the fact that, okay, they are brain damaged. Okay, this is going on. Well, they did autopsies a few years after the war on people dying. You can look this up. It was even in Life magazine. And found that they had nerve gas, sarin, VX, and other agents in their brain stems. And that's finally what killed them, was losing motor control. And finally, they can't breathe anymore and suffocate. So you go from being, I'm a Marine Corps colonel, Mr. Tough Guy, to your wife changing your diapers, to fighting for your life, then on a respirator, then dead. And they knew, folks, just like they knew the dust at the World Trade Center was deadly day one, and said, take off your respirators. You don't even need them. Because if they would have said issue respirators, they would have had to admit that the dust was deadly. And you ask, why do they do this? It's not just that life's cheap. They enjoy killing you. Bayer Pharmaceutical, as you know, about 8 years ago, was found guilty in France. They also were criminally in trouble in Australia. Nothing even happened here. And the documents came out in the court case. It was on NBC News, you name it. Just type in Bayer blood scandal. And they knew that every ampule of factor VIII for hemophiliacs and other disorders was filled with a megadose of HIV, hepatitis, multiple types of hepatitis. It was a death sentence injected into people with compromised immune systems. A death sentence. And they had the corporate minutes where for a decade they were in there suppressing their own sub-executives who didn't want to be part of it. Because it was seen as a public service to kill hemophiliacs. So I want you all to listen to me and listen real good. I don't like having to do this job. I never thought of myself as being one of the most prominent people in this fight. I don't have all the answers. I don't want to be your leader. I don't claim to do an even near perfect job. But we're the best there is here at InfoWars.com. And I've done the research. And quite frankly, things are much worse than I can even explain here because there's so much. I mean, look at just the news from today here on my desk if you're watching us on TV. There's probably 200 news articles here, each one more important than the last. All I can say to you out there, all I can say to you is that I know there are a lot of smart professional people out there who've been taught their entire life that getting ahead means not taking risk, going with the flow, and working in the system. And I know a lot of you know this, but you say, well, how are you going to change it? What are we going to do about it? The public's dumbed down. Nobody cares. If you have that attitude, it is a death sentence to you and your family. Look at the numbers. If you look at neurological disorders, if you look at all the different diseases increasing, everything, no one is going to escape this. And your progeny, your children, their children, the whole future of humanity is being cursed by the pollution of evil, the corruption that's going on right now. Everything is organized around being anti-human. And so as long as it hurts humans, it's authorized and encouraged. And the worst of the worst have competed to get in positions of power. And they really enjoy trying to forcibly inoculate you and your family, not to protect you from pathogens, but to brain damage you and hurt you on record. Just like the fluoride, just like the glyphosates, just like the additives that are put in so many things. This is all done publicly to so poison and so intoxicate humanity that we're basically walking dead. And we're not walking dead yet, but we're getting close to it. Even the best of our species show the wear and tear from this poisoning process. And this is the big enchilada. They knew when they blew up giant chemical weapons bases. He had like the fourth biggest stockpile, it was estimated. I was doing some research again last night. Saddam had one of the biggest caches of chemical weapons in the world. It had been mainly sold to him by the U.S. The U.S. had given him satellite trajectory and weather maps on how to fire it and artillery and spray it out of helicopters on the Iranians. They always go, he used gas on his own people. Yeah, and our criminal government commanded him and ran that operation. And then they blow it all up, just huge caches of it. It rains down over the region. Our troops would only pull back, in some cases, 5-6 miles and would have convulsions on the spot, would be coughing, eyes watering. And all of this is going on. Yeah, there's AP. Rumsfeld helped Iraq get chemical weapons. Yeah, he helped Iran get weapons. He helped North Korea get nuclear reactors. And they knew when they blew all these, over 200 facilities, big ones, many of them huge, that it would rain down. And then they said, oh, your detectors are going off? False alarm. Remember you heard on the news? Chemical weapons alarms. False alarm, false alarm. And then they didn't give them treatment when they go in. They won't give them surgeries. They won't give them help. They give them Prozac. I mean, that's what they think about all of you folks. Okay, we have really bad people that have been known to do secret experiments in control.
In the last two...
want to be clear, ladies and gentlemen. So many new listeners say, man, this guy is so negative. I don't want to hear this. No, I'm telling you that major studies have shown that Roundup, I mean, they've got movies about it with George Clooney, for heaven's sakes, is massively increasing cancer. And I'm here telling you we need to do something about it. I'm here telling you they put fluoride in the water to give you cancer and dumb you down, and they're on record doing it. Let's get moving and warn people. I guess this show is negative if you don't think anything of yourself and you just think you have no power. Me, I take all this real personal, and I'm angry and I'm focused. And here's something else. I don't apologize for going to the BBC and getting in their presenter's face who was laughing at me. I don't apologize for getting in the face of Piers Morgan. I don't apologize to get in the face of FBI agents on video when they've gotten in my face. I've done nothing wrong. I'm here trying to wake people up, and I'm sick of the globalists trying to keep everybody calm. They're like, oh, the way to be credible is to stay calm. Bull. They've taught you it's all about staying calm and wearing a psychopath suit and sitting there lying to people with a bunch of crooks in Congress and crooks on national TV. All acting calm and everything's normal and everybody don't upset anybody. That's because they don't want you to awaken. Coming up, confidence in newspapers at near record lows, polls find. Oh, really? UPI. Poll, Obama approval rating plunges more. The most on people under 30, 17 points. You lost the trendy factor, Bubba. Guess who's way up in under 30? Infowars.com. Poll, Obama approval rating drops amid slew of controversies. What's the problem with that, though? He's just a puppet. The system needs to lose credibility. The Federal Reserve, the private offshore banking cartel. But it's called federal. Maybe Jeffrey Dahmer should have called himself Federal Reserve. The cops would have just walked off and said, oh, continue murdering people. Poll, confidence in Congress at all-time low. Again, the good news is people know they're being lied to. They know they're being screwed over. But that isn't enough, folks. The system knows you're waking up, so they're buying armored vehicles, building bases, billions of bullets, training for war against us. We've got to get aggressive and in their face now, and we've got to vote with our dollars and support alternative and real media, and we all need to run for office, and we all just need to swarm the system with so many different actions, there's no way they can respond to it. Even if they've got AI predictive systems that can pretty much gauge the future to a great extent, it won't matter. They'll just see their own doom. Now false flag's a household word. They've got mainstream news articles I saw this weekend in Britain and the U.S. saying, did the U.S. and NATO stage the chemical attack? These people predicted it. These people are us. You see, I just want humanity to survive. I don't understand what's so alien about that. People think they get ahead screwing other people. And that's not how you get ahead long term, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to stop preaching. I'll get to all this news with Max Keiser coming up. We'll take phone calls, I promise. Wide open phones in the third hour. Briefly, ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you about some of the sponsors that make our broadcast possible. One of them is Infidel Body Armor. You can go to their website and see their amazing catalog of everything from backpacks to body armor, backpack body armor. It's all available, ladies and gentlemen, on their website at infidelbodyarmor.com. One word, infidelbodyarmor.com. And regular body armor only stops about six rounds. This stops hundreds. Go check it out. InfidelBodyArmor.com or 888-608-6605. 888-608-6605. And don't forget, we have ProPure water filters at the lowest price. Discounted 10% off with promo code WATER at InfoWarsStore.com. And get your PrisonPlanet.tv memberships as well. Well, Edward Snowden tells the press in an online press conference, but the truth is coming out. The government can't stop by murdering me. But he goes on to say they want to murder him. The Chinese government's come out and said he's not working for them. And said it's ridiculous that Dick Cheney said that. If anybody's working for the communist Chinese, it's Dick Cheney. And the Bushes and all them opening up China and selling us out to them. Bill Clinton, all of them. It's just ridiculous. Give up your rights to the military-industrial complex. The Chinese communists will get us. The globalists put them in power. Kicked out Chiang Kai-shek. Unbelievable. That's just some of what is coming up on that front. We're going to be joined as well by Max Keiser. He's got a new article out that's just went up on Infowars.com. The collapse of the current bankster regime is upon us is his headline, and he wrote this article for Infowars.com. So we've got that article up there right now. He will be joining us. He said you'd see a dollar plunge and a worldwide stock market plunge starting at the end of April, early May, and he'll tell you that he's a month and a half off. That's what he was saying a week and a half ago. I still wasn't convinced completely, but more and more I hope he's wrong. Even though it's a fiat system, we're riding on top of it. And it's just the Federal Reserve hinting at ending QE4 or QE Unlimited or QE Infinity, which is just free money to them that they loan out to us at 10, 20, 30%. Just hinting at that to show how kept we are, how controlled we are by these foreign offshore banks has sent the stock market the last few weeks, as you know, going downward. So we're going to be looking at that with Max Keiser here in the next segment. First, I'll get into the latest NSA news as well. And again, I got into the fact, just to illustrate who the globalists are, they knew blowing up nerve gas caches would maim and kill many of our troops and debilitate them. That's now admitted in the New York Times. Just shows you who these people are. California allows up to 1,000 times glyphosate that they know. 1,000 times lesser massively increases breast cancer. Venezuela considers banning baby bottle feeding because it makes the brain smaller, the IQs lower, and the children unhealthy. Yeah, it's all done by the eugenicist to have the working class basically brain damage the children. I mean, it's all, and they've known this for 50, 60 years. Of course they've known it. How many controversies have they had where babies, guys, will you print me an article on this because it sounds insane. Just type in baby formula, baby deaths. You'll see stuff in China and India and Africa where the globalists really sell the bad stuff, where the babies just die. Here, they know that'd be a little too obvious, so they just, get ready to have, one of people getting, diabetes when they're five? Well, you're getting, 75% high fructose corn syrup and sugar in the average baby formula. I mean, of course, your pancreas is dead on arrival. But what's wrong with having your arms and legs sawed off? I mean, I got a buddy right now who's got diabetes, might have to get his toe chopped off. What's wrong with that? That's loving and liberal. It's trendy. I mean, what's wrong with Bayer putting HIV in the shots for hemophiliacs? It's loving. It's trendy. Of course, I'm being sickeningly sarcastic. This stuff gets to me. And that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm exposing. That's what I'm angry about. So I'm recapping that for people that joined us. But I've got about 15 stacks of news here I've not yet gotten to. And we're going to go over it all with Max Keiser on the other side of this quick break. But first, is this his prediction a month and a half late coming true? Another article by Paul Joseph Watson that just went up. Did Israel attack Syria again? Strike on advanced weapons shipment threatens huge escalation of conflict. The Saudi Arabians are announcing they're going to ship missiles to Al-Qaeda. Unbelievable. And when Al-Qaeda blows up U.S. airliners with these missiles, will they invade a country not involved again, like Iraq? Probably. Probably, because there's a war against reality going on. Stay with us. I'm your host, Alex Jones, Prison Planet. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the second hour of this worldwide broadcast. It is Monday, the 17th day of June, 2013. We're going to be joined by market analyst and journalist Max Keiser here in a moment to talk about the world economic condition is at the beginning of a crash that Max has been predicting for about a year that he thought would start in late April or early May. Was he late predicting it? His article on Infowars.com, the collapse of the current bankster regime is upon us. Well, they've been collapsing it by design, but too big to fail. So, I mean, we're going to talk to Max here in a moment. First off, Snowden gave a two-hour online press conference to the media. Business Insider linked up on drudgereport.com. We'll get it posted on Infowars.com as well. The truth is coming, and the government can't stop it by murdering me. And he went on to say a lot more is coming out and that he thinks they're going to try to kill him. Well, yeah, it came out in the news. The Daily Mail was at Dulles Airport and heard a bunch of government CIA spooks talking about how they want to kill him and how they're going to kill him. It's a mafia, folks, of foreign banks that run the intelligence agencies. And the big secret about the NSA is not a secret at all. Thousands of major companies have partial access. The Fortune 100 have total access, and they make the money off of spying on everything and swapping the data, and then they use it to corner the market. And what did Bloomberg report on Friday? What Max Keiser and I have told you for a long time. The stock market is totally rigged. These companies are rigged. But only the big top insiders are allowed to have offshore bank accounts and deals offshore with corporations and trust and tax shelters where they pay no taxes. General Electric, Google, Berkshire Hathaway. Only the insiders are allowed to use the inside info. So it's a globally gamed system. And it's not enough for the bankers to have unlimited fiat currency for themselves and to be able to create endless derivatives. They've expanded the derivatives market the last few years. It's not enough to have us then tied to their debt. Then they have all the inside data on everything. If a company's coming out with something that's going to block them, not part of the insiders, they try to buy it for pennies on the dollar. If they won't sell, boom, the IRS and regulators are turned loose on them. If that doesn't work, they just kill you. Industrial espionage. They call it a disruptive technology. Warehouses of incredible energy devices. Warehouses of incredible medical treatments that are then only given to the establishment. And that's what a major Russian tycoon is in the news talking about today. But they know you're going to want to have access to all this. That's why they're putting the police state grid in place. Look at this. GCHQ intercepted foreign politicians' communications at G20 summits. Oh, really? And again, the idea is that America and England were spying for our countries. We're run by big mega banks who own subsidiaries in all these countries. They use it to make sure they get their outcome. Do you understand that? They're deindustrializing us. Here's another one. The next NSA spying shoe to drop, pre-crime artificial intelligence. That's up on Infowars.com. Yeah, where they say you're guilty when you're not really guilty. They can also then not just predict the future with these systems, they can then program the future. Documents uncovered by Snowden show British eavesdropping by GCHQ. Again, repeatedly hacking in diplomats' phones, emails report. G20 summit, NSA targeted Russian President Medvedev in London. Folks, when I was inside a Bilderberg meeting after they'd already closed it down in 2008, every major room, conference room, was jammed full of spy equipment with people openly going, I got a Navy satellite. I got an Air Force satellite. It's a GM7Q overlay. I told you. And there was like people talking in French and German and Israeli, and each room was allowed to spy on the other. It's an incredibly important summit. Continuing, Dick Cheney's suggestion Snowden, a Chinese spy, is sheer nonsense, say the Chinese. I mean, if anybody's a Chinese spy, it's Cheney and the globalist. Edward Snowden, again, is not a Chinese spy, says Beijing. Cheney calls Snowden a traitor, says Rand Paul, wrong about surveillance. So it's all for our safety, right, Cheney? And it goes on and on and on and on. And then you've got CIA whistleblower in prison for reporting on waterboarding. This is the type of garbage that's happening. I'm going to go to our guest and get into the economic news and the latest on all the NSA spying. But China is teetering on the brink. Have a stack of news. Finch says China credit bubble unprecedented in modern world history. All of these credit bubbles are the same corporate interest accelerating money printing bubbles and fiat bubbles to take over the world and then sign us on to their debt and then pose as the saviors during the global reorganization. And so I agree with Keiser that we're already in a world meltdown with him lying and saying the economy's gotten great, with the globalists picking winners and losers. But I believe from their own statements, it is an engineered collapse. Now, the question is, will they ride this out? But he said a year ago it would happen in April, and it didn't happen in April. He said late April. But it was a bold prediction. Now much of what he predicted is starting to happen. I wouldn't say he's been proven correct yet, but I was watching CNBC this morning, and they were all the pundits. Now, they may zig when they zag, so it may be the opposite, but they were saying, yeah, it looks like the Fed's going to start tapering. Yeah, things are going to implode. Outlook's bad. What does that mean? It means they'll start a war as a political distraction, which you now see happening. So I see a lot of indicators there that the big collapse could be beginning to arrive. Now, I hope that's not the case. But joining us is Max Keiser, who, of course, invented the Hollywood Stock Exchange, which is the basis of a lot of the virtual trading used today, and was a very successful stockbroker before, I guess, retiring at like age 40. And he joins us now. He writes for a lot of major publications, MaxKeiser.com, and has a show on RT as well, and has had shows on BBC. Max, you heard me kind of set the table there. Thank you for joining us from London. What do you make of my take on this, and what is happening right now?
Yeah, so the dollar turns on interest rates, and interest rates are starting to move up. Now, this is pretty much going to put the kibosh on global bond markets and stock markets. And the rhetoric coming out of the mainstream financial press as of a couple of months ago was that rising interest rates were telegraphing increased growth, that there was an increased growth in the economy. But since then, all the major economies have reported their GDPs are down, employment is flat to stagnating. So the reason interest rates are going up is not because of growth, but because of fear. Fear that this unwinding of this epic bubble is happening. And so this is what I said would happen. And the rising interest rates are telling us that that is exactly what is happening. So look for interest rates to continue to go higher. This means that anyone with mortgages, variable rate mortgages, particularly in the UK, what they call the mortgages that are set, variable rate mortgages, tracker mortgages, will be underwater very quickly on any houses that they bought. And, of course, George Osborne, the Chancellor of the Exchequer, has been fueling a massive Ponzi scheme here in the UK by having the government guarantee mortgages up to 20% of a mortgage under a scheme called Help to Buy. He's actually mirroring the catastrophe that was Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac that led to the collapse of housing in America. So George Osborne is doing that now. He's just started that program here. So this, of course, will also end in disaster.
Now, for laymen out there, describe the economic situation we're in, why this is happening, and any other tricks they may have up their sleeve to extend the incremental collapse out that they want to properly milk us and then draw and quarter us, rather than a big accelerated collapse, which they fear, in their own words, I saw Jim Cramer this morning saying, stop the derivatives. You're coming out with synthetic derivatives. The people aren't going to put up with it. Stop it. You guys are going to get us all in trouble. But it doesn't matter, because the more aggressive criminals, and Cramer admits that he's an insider trading criminal in videos, the more aggressive criminals, the suicide traders, as you call them, they're in control.
Yeah, well, to give the context of this, over the past 30 to 40 years, it's been a race between those who are creating debt and the growth that we see in the economy. And sometimes there is a positive GDP growth despite the increase in debt. Sometimes debt is growing faster than GDP, and we call those periods recessions. And when growth is outstripping debt, we call those periods of growth. But starting in 2008, the world now is in 5 years of debt increasing without any growth, really appreciable growth anywhere in the world. And it was even just 6 months ago, China was considered to be growing. Now it's considered to be contracting, or its growth rate de-accelerating. So there's no growth to get people out of this debt. The derivatives pile, the synthetic derivatives pile, the massive pile that Cramer's talking about, is growing. Now, is there another trick up the sleeve of the global banksters? There is another trick that they could do, which is that they could take up to $100 trillion worth of bad debt, combine them in Europe, the U.S., and Asia into a new bond that they could create based on the IMF monetizing this paper their special drawing right, or SDR. With, you know, the IMF is like a central bank in that respect, like the ECB or the Federal Reserve. It has its own currency, the special drawing rights, or the SDR. And two or three years ago at Davos, one of the people attending Davos mentioned that they could float a $100 trillion loan facility to roll up all this bad sovereign debt into a super global...
And then back it with carbon taxes. Stay there. We'll be right back with the $100 trillion global government tax.
We need it the most.
Again, if you just tuned in, I'm Alex Jones. I'm your host. I'm a libertarian constitutionalist. Constitutionalist populist. I just want justice. I want freedom. And so I'm demonized by basically every publication in the United States. Every establishment publication, from National Review to MSNBC, from Bill O'Reilly to CNN. And I just have a sick feeling that I've never had before about America and just about the world. I'm very, 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 very upset because I don't get up here and talk about world economic collapses to have a shocking headline. I know when they get up there on all the financial shows and say, it's the best economy ever, everything's wonderful. I know what's happening in the real economy. I know about municipalities going bankrupt all over the U.S. and all over the world. I know about Europe being signed on to derivative debts that aren't their debts in any case. Trillions and trillions of dollars designed to bankrupt us. I see governments gearing up for oppression. I see just brazen criminal activity by the government and corporations, and it freaks me out. And so I look for places to move, places to run. There is nowhere. It's a global corporate government, and I've seen them go from on MSNBC and CNN from saying the economy is wonderful to, oh my gosh, we're in trouble, which means that they may be getting ready to drop the hammer because they want to at least act like, with short attention spans of the public, that they knew what they were talking about. They know the truth. And they could have fixed this, is what's sad about it, but they cannot turn back from this gulag casino model that Max Keiser talks about. This is a short segment, long segment coming up, Max, but are you dreading this as much as I am? I mean, how are you handling this emotionally? And at your gut level, I mean, how bad is it? What do you really think is going to happen, Max?
Well, hey, first of all, you know, we miss you here in the UK. When you were here, the media and the TV shows were interesting for a few days. Now it's back to the same old boring BBC and same old
nonsense. When are you coming back?
Well, Max, I don't know. I don't know if I can run the gauntlet there and, you know, back to the here in the U.S. The point I'm getting at here is how bad is it currently right now?
Well, it's a slow motion train wreck that is brought about by too much debt. I mean, I guess you could imagine that you've got this train and it's pulling debt. The American economy is the engine and it's pulling debt. And the government is adding more cars of debt to this train, and it's slowing down and slowing down, and it's coming to a complete stop. And then people are panicking all over the world. And you, look what's happening in Chicago. Look at all the violence. Look what's happening in Detroit. The state is about to go bankrupt. That's a direct result of this problem. It's just happening in a regional basis, but that's a direct result of what exactly we're talking about. So you say, when's it going to happen? When's the collapse going to happen? Well, in Detroit, it's happened already. In Chicago, it's become more violent than Iraq. I mean, this is already happening. So it's happening right now. It's just, it hasn't happened from coast to coast as such, but it's happening in these pockets that are exploding in the United States and in cities all over the world because it's all connected to the same problem. And it'll happen here in the UK, of course, and more obviously in the short term.
And that's what the martial law buildup is mainly for, is just the clampdown and taking everybody's private bank accounts and the Boy Scouts serving in FEMA brigades. I mean, it's just...
Well, we had an example of it here in the UK this week. There's a bank called Co-op Bank. It wasn't big enough to be too big to fail. So instead, they're going to do a bail-in. So the bondholders of the bank are going to have to pony up some cash. So this is another trend we've seen in the last couple of years. If you're part of the too-big-to-fail bank, then the government bails out the bondholders and you're sweet. If you're not part of that club, then you could be in Cyprus, you could be part of Co-op Bank, you could be part of some other bank or country, and therefore you get your wealth confiscated. So wealth confiscation is a trend that became very obvious with Cyprus, and now it's getting growing in different regions. They're talking about it in Japan. Remember 10 months ago or 11 months ago when I said that there's this global bond apocalypse on the horizon, I said the number one trigger for this would be Japan. And since that time, we have had a huge economic volatility happening in Japan as that market goes through a gut-wrenching bond collapse as well as a stock market volatility. So we're seeing it happen there because they've had two decades of what they call lost decades. They can't stimulate using debt, and they can't export their way into growth. So this could be the sinkhole around which all these other...
Yeah, you did say a year ago it would start in Japan, and much of what you predicted is now starting to happen. I want to talk about short-term, mid-term, long-term, what you think is going to happen next, gold, and a lot more. What we're seeing is a revolution by technocrats using NSA systems to rig the markets, to spy on their competition. So how do we have a revolution against criminal revolutionaries that got control in 1913 of the issuance of our currency and have now gotten control of most of our society? They've been dumbing us down for a long time. What do you do when they publicly run Al-Qaeda and are giving them missiles, and Saudi Arabia says give them more missiles, which is just the cover to claim they gave them the missiles they really got from Benghazi? And I see articles like this all the time here in the U.S. now. Here's one out of WHAM television. Man charged after corralling suspected vandals in a closet. He came in where they'd done $40,000 worth of damage. They've been indicted for that, with a hammer knocking holes in the wall. He grabbed the hammer away and said, wait here for police. And he's now been indicted. He's now been charged. So that's how. A Wayne County man is now facing charges, four charges of endangering the welfare of a child after he interrupted an act of vandalism. See, he didn't even touch any of them. But you don't have a right to citizen's arrest now. In England, if you fight back with your fist with someone trying to stab you in your home, they will, even if you get stabbed and you beat them up, they will indict you, throw you in prison, because there's nothing more evil than a citizen defending themselves. That's the great crime to a criminal government, to a nanny state. I want to get this guy on the show. And then I've got all this other NSA news about how they retina scan kids all over the country when they get on the school bus and don't tell the parents. Same thing was done in England a few years ago. It's a global unified program of just the good fellas that are a bunch of corporate crooks taking over. So, Max, let me ask you this question. Break it down in layman terms. What do you expect to see now in the economy? How bad will it get? And what other rabbits can they pull? You mentioned some of those. What will that do? And how do you, looking out in the future, how do you expect this in your gut to end? What does Max Keiser think is really going to happen?
Well, the two important numbers are inflation and the rate at which wages are growing. Now, we know wages are flat to contracting. Adjusted for inflation, real wages haven't grown in 10 years. But inflation is growing. So the government says it's running at 2.5% to 3% here in the U.S. or the U.K. But if you look at the price of what stuff really buy, gasoline, food, et cetera, it's running at 8%, 9%. So that trend is where people make direct contact with how these policies are hurting them. Their dollars are losing purchasing power, and their standard of living is decreasing, and they don't have any wage growth to offset that. And that trend will continue. There's over the past 50 years or so, there was a bit of a correlation between stock prices and wages. A lot of times, you would see stock prices go up and wages would go up. But this past 5 years during the stock market rally that has made many billionaires many, many times richer, wages have stayed flat. So the financial engineers have perfected a technique where they can increase asset values, that is to say stocks and stuff like art, fine art, yachts, et cetera, things that the billionaires buy. They figured out a way to get those prices to keep going higher without increasing wages. So that's been the experiment that's been on for 30 years. I finally have perfected this. So there's no reason to stop because the cost of labor is not going to go higher, no matter how much money they print and to put in their own pocket. Wages are just not going to go higher. So
exactly. It's now an inflation only in luxury goods. Everything else is imploding, and then they'll just... People only have jobs as cops or prison guards, and so we go into the gulag economy. It's all been, well, Rand Corporation, as you know, wrote about it 50 years ago. They've really done a great job.
Yeah, there's no way that wages are ever going to match inflation in the foreseeable future. So, and of course, the unions, which were in place to defend the worker, they've been completely destroyed. Now, of course, you can say, well, unions are run by corrupt union officials. That's true. And union officials have done a lot to destroy the unions. But nevertheless, now you have a situation where there's absolutely no one lobbying on behalf of workers at all. There's nobody lobbying for workers, for wages. I've said, and this is true economically, that if you simply paid out wages to workers and you tripled or quadrupled the minimum wage and financed it with the same 0% interest rates from the Federal Reserve that Citibank can get or Lloyd's of London can get, then you could have an economy that was growing both from workers and asset owners. But they don't want to do that. They don't want to share anything. They just want to
create what's
a situation
the plan
where they take all the profits and leave nothing.
What's the plan to bring in 30 million illegals? I mean, the globalists are all for it, Republicans and Democrats. I just look at it and say, I can't go to Mexico and have a baby for free. I can't get on welfare there. I'm all for workers to this country, and I'm all for immigrants. My issue is that they are now basically corporate minions and are going to be used to drive down wages even further, and that's the goal.
Right, cheap labor. Of course that's the goal. Cheap labor is desirable. And as long as these people have no rights, as long as they are one step out of prison, or, you know, the biggest working population in America right now are actually prisoners.
Yeah.
You know, because
yeah,
there was an overturn of a law recently that made it legal, once again, to outsource labor to prison. And not only are judges throwing kids into prison on spurious claims to feed the prison industrial complex, but now they're putting people in prison because that's now become a cheap source of labor. Now, this is a complete repudiation of laws against slave labor. So slavery is legal in America. Anyone who thinks that slavery was outlawed is wrong. Slavery is completely legal in America, again.
I totally agree. In fact, when you see them passing a law where even many wooden pipes, it says some wooden pipes are okay, but if you read the definition of hookahs and things, it's not, where a felony to have a pipe. And then you see stuff where they tell the kid, take your NRA shirt off, but the school didn't have a code against, you know, non-profane lettering. So they charge him with the gun on his shirt being a terroristic threat. And then they tell kids at commencements that they can't thank God when that's their free speech, whether you believe in God or not. I mean, I just see cases every day of how wildly authoritarian things are and how the law is designed to let violent offenders go, but keep the nonviolent people actually in the prisons working for 25 cents an hour. That's how they legalize slavery, is they just pass a bunch of laws now where 0.5, that's half a beer. You know, you're going to get a felony now and go to jail. They want all of us in the system.
All right. Well, the country with the biggest prison population in the world is the United States. Bigger than China, bigger than any country in the world, it's the United States because it's such a hugely profitable business. And the thing about the Second Amendment or gun rights is that it's a hot button issue. So a lot of people will be out there defending their Second Amendment rights, but sacrifice their First, Third, Fourth, Fifth, Sixth Amendment rights. So it's very unbalanced. The pro-gun debate is unbalanced in that people are willing to defend their Second Amendment rights, but sacrifice their First Amendment right, or the Third or Fourth Amendment right. So there is a bit of a confusion, I think, in the overall pushback against this NSA prism style gulag state. And remember, the prison gulag state needs a prism to make it work, and now we know, thanks to Edward Snowden, that there is a prism. The prison, you know, you should change the name of Prison Planet to Prison Planet, because now we all live in this NSA prism dome of perpetual surveillance. And I thought the interview with Edward Snowden today was pretty interesting, in that he touched on a lot of very interesting points, and I am in the camp that gives him 100% credibility, along with Glenn Greenwald. So there is at least a few people out there who have managed to blow the whistle, come forward, and give the administration some hot flashes.
Well, I love how over and over again we see Cheney and neocons come out and say, arrest this guy. He's a traitor. He must work for the Chinese. These are the guys that transferred our missile secrets, our reactor secrets, our technology, our jobs, bipartisanly, the Democrats are involved as well, to communist China because they could get fat cat state-guaranteed deals with them. Now they're busy selling off. I was watching this morning CNBC, like I said, and they were just, even the hosts were like, my God, they're buying up the entire infrastructure because America sold out. MIT has come out and admitted that the jobs are never coming back because we sold out the infrastructure. The elite here will no longer be the elite. They were so greedy, they even destroyed their own command base, Max Keiser. And so my point is, it's so rich how this military-industrial complex talks about how it's taking our rights to protect us, when everybody knows they run Al-Qaeda, they run the Chi-Coms, everything bad, they run it.
Well, you make a good point there, that the Dick Cheney's of the world are pointing to foreign powers and saying we need to protect ourselves against them invading, while at the same time he's cutting deals with the exact same foreign powers to buy huge pieces of America's infrastructure. China, in particular, is buying up big pieces of American industry, as are other countries around the world. And the reason why they're cutting deals now is because of the huge debt that America has, that they realize that the only way they can settle this debt is to sell off these big pieces of the infrastructure. And you see, you saw this in Greece. You know, Greece was a country that before Goldman Sachs and John Paulson and Papandreou, the prime minister, got involved, it was a $400 billion economy. It was determined that it wasn't that big of an economy. It was, after all, maybe only two times the size of IBM or two times the size of Berkshire Hathaway. And you could effectively do a leveraged buyout of Greece, and that's exactly what they did. They went in there, they flooded it with lots of bad debt. They transferred that debt to the government. The government then transferred that debt to the people through austerity. The economy has collapsed, and now they're selling off the assets. A few weeks ago, for the first time, one of the Greek islands was sold to a Qatar, one of the top guys in Qatar, the emir of Qatar, and that opened the floodgates for these kleptocrats and oligarchs to start buying these Greek islands. So now,
just like Detroit created taxes that ran everybody out, set up this corrupt bureaucracy, and now they're fully collapsing. That is the model. But I think this is so out of control, they may not get away with it. Let me show TV viewers and radio listeners a couple articles here. The New York Times, police officers arrested a protester in Istanbul on Sunday, the same day Prime Minister rallied supporters. So he was allowed to have people come out and rally for him, but people that just rallied to keep the only park in the city, the only green space open where they play soccer, it shows the police, it looks like breaking the guy's arm. You can see they've twisted it back so far. No way that didn't break. And stomping him in the head, and the New York Times goes with police arrest. See, they just ignore everything is propaganda. Let's go to the next article. For many, no penalty for crimes. Drunk driving, shoplifting, breaking in homes. The police, it says they made the decision to not arrest for petty crimes. Meanwhile, the code is illegal aliens, folks. It's illegal aliens. They don't arrest. And again, though, citizens get pulled over with no seatbelt. You go to jail in Austin, and they throw the book at you because we're seen as milk cows, Max Keiser.
Yeah, well, I think it's important for people to understand that when you talk about the New York Times, you're talking about a captured journalistic enterprise. They are not giving you unbiased truth. This is an institution that's gone horribly wrong. So has all of the big media outlets in the U.S. I mean, your show is delivering great information with the Texas Twister. You know, this is what the most people don't understand in the foreign press, that in America now, the media landscape is so horrid and so decrepit and so immoral that the only way you can get through the prison of lies is through this, you know, grenade approach, which if you get past the first couple of shockwaves, you end up getting a lots and lots of really great information. So we want to thank you for that. And again, I will repeat that wherever I go in the world, people always say, oh, yeah, I heard you on Alex Jones. Not that they heard me on the BBC or they heard me on this other outlet. They say, oh, I heard you on Alex Jones. So you've got this huge global audience with people waking up to this. And it's sad, though, that the country that's the most to lose is the United States. The people of the United States, they were holding all the cards. And now they've given it all back to the people like Dick Cheney. And Dick Cheney, if there's a traitor in the mix, it's not Edward Snowden. It's Dick Cheney. Look at Dick Cheney's track record and selling America's freedom down the rat hole for what? A few extra dollars? What was his incentive? Is he that shallow? Is he that callous that he would just blow America?
Well, that's even what the big Pentagon war planners say is they're getting. Wait, the military-industrial complex and the banks, they have one thing, profit, but it's even destroying America's empire in the future. So they're even getting, wait, we're going to lose the golden goose because Dick Cheney and Bill Clinton and others slaughtered it. It's incredible. We're going to go to break and come back with Max Keiser, and I'm going to find out if we can hold Max a little bit in the next hour to take your economic phone calls, and then I'll open the phones up just for general calls after Max leaves us. But he may have to leave in 10 minutes, so we'll see if this is the final segment when we come back with Max Keiser. I'll ask him during the break. But I just want callers to understand something. We have a normalcy bias in this country to basically put up with anything. We've gotten to where we're in a position where we'll put up with almost anything. And it's time for just across the board to stop complying and to realize we're in deep trouble. I mean, I fundamentally think about my children every day and try to figure out ways to fix this country so they have a future. And then get angry that it's a global government and that I can't leave. I mean, we're cornered. We've got to get out of here. The only way to beat this is to bring down the New World Order. They're bringing down free societies to collapse it into their controlled paradigm because they're in control. They can do that. And it is madness. We're going to go to break and come back with Max Keiser. Just briefly, the trailer will be out tomorrow. You can pre-order it now. It's only available at Infowars.com. I'm in it. It's State of Mind, the psychology of control. It's about the past, the present, and the future of mind control. It's very well done. The same makers are the people that put out Oklahoma City, A Noble Lie. The film is available in Blu-ray and DVD right now, and it's got everybody in it, a bunch of doctors and scientists and G. Edward Griffin and Colonel Schaefer and myself and so many others. So State of Mind, the psychology of control, and for the first 5,000 people that ordered it, that sounds like a lot, it's not, you will get free the film exposing the private Federal Reserve, The American Dream. I have 5,000 of these. When they're gone, that's it. We never offer a new film with something free out of the gates, but I'm doing this now because State of Mind is so important. Order it today, InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsStore.com. Alex Jones here, back live. Max Keiser has agreed to stay 20, 30 minutes with us into the next hour to take your calls on the economy and on world events. You want to talk to Max, have a question or comment for himself from yours truly, Alex Jones. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231, and we'll get you up and on the air. Here are some of the headlines up on Infowars.com. Ron Paul is saying Obama's Syria policy looks a lot like Bush's Iraq policy. Max Keiser, the collapse of the current bankster regime is upon us. He breaks that down. Journalist says TSA shamed my teenage daughter. Russian tycoon predicts immortality within 25 years, 14-year-old faces year in jail over pro-gun T-shirt. They say the image of the rifle is a terroristic threat, a thought crime. The next NSA snooping shoe to drop pre-crime, and it just goes on and on from there. Oh, and the French government's coming out and saying, look, we met with Britain 2 years ago about launching this current war. That's because the war started 2 years ago against Syria. Max, you were telling me you've got some breaking news dealing with McDonald's. Tell us about it.
Oh, yeah, this just came out. McDonald's is now being sued by one of their workers because they've got a deal with J.P. Morgan where their payroll goes directly into a J.P. Morgan account. And J.P. Morgan then charges people $1.50 to use the ATM. Then they charge them $1 to just see what their balance is for a balance inquiry. They charge them 75 cents per online bill payment, $15 for a lost card.
And they force them to use that bank. I mean, that is slavery.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
That is, yeah. So the
And that's what they're going to do when they get their cashless society completely in place. They've said it.
Yeah, I mean, in other words, getting back to what we were saying before, wages are never going to go up. I mean, here's, they can raise the minimum wage to $8 or $9 or $10, but J.P. Morgan will just raise their fees by $1 an hour, $2 an hour, and they'll just put that money directly into J.P. Morgan's pocket. That's what we've seen now post-crash of 2008.
And that was my next point. You said this years ago, it's now on record. The NSA is there to give private companies intelligence on how to game the economy, the stock market, LIBOR, all of it. And that came out last week that indeed the NSA is using this data to corner markets. I mean, it's incredible. They are waging war against real economies.
Well, there's a scandal of high-frequency trading. The traders who use this high-frequency trading, they're trading a billion times per second on the New York Stock Exchange and other exchanges. They say that they're adding liquidity and they're making a market. Now it comes out that the regulators are releasing prices at a fraction of a second before they do release to the public to give insiders insider information. Then that came out at about the same time that the NSA Prism story broke. So that confirms now. And also for Congress, congressional aides and others in Washington, insider trading is legal. It has not been outlawed. So here you have an NSA with unlimited computer power and 360-degree spy presence with a high-frequency trader on Wall Street that's totally captured all the regulators who are trading on inside information. So that's why the economy is the way it is. That's why people can't make enough to get ahead of inflation while simultaneously the top 5,000 people are billionaire, are increasing at 30 or 40% a year. That's how you do it.
Stay there, Max Keiser, because here's the rest of the story. We're going to get your take on this when we come back. The globalist are then funding socialism and fake grassroots communism to then scapegoat the giant poor mass off against what's left of the middle class to usher in total social control and government engineering out of the crisis. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now into hour number three, taking your phone calls for the next half hour. Then I'm going to get into the rest of the news I've not yet covered and take your phone calls. Look at this. Sesame Street says P is for prison, and that's okay. Everything. You know, they show police stomping some guy and breaking his arm on the cover of the New York Times and say, police arrest a protester. It's like they just are preparing us for total enslavement. And all the kleptocratic class and the media and the government corporations think it's going to protect them. I'll get Max Keiser's take on that and more coming up. But right now, let's go to calls as promised for Max Keiser. Mike in Oregon, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, guys. How's it going? I just want to thank you a lot for getting me on the show.
Thank you, brother.
And I just want to, no problem. Hey, Max, I'm a guy who's making about, $12,000, $13,000 a year. What can I do as a small investor to give my money more purchase power? Should I invest into prison places or defense contractors? I was going to see what take I can get from you on which way to go.
Well, that's a good question because the way the economy is set up is it forces people to pick sides like this. And it's just like Nazi Germany. People knew that people were being sent to the gas oven. but they were benefiting from the gold that was being extracted from the teeth and the clothes that were being stolen and the wealth that was being stolen.
Mm-hmm.
And isn't it sad that in America people have to make this choice, that they don't get paid adequately? So with the money they do get paid, should they invest in Monsanto, the agricultural terrorists? Should they invest in Corrections Corps of America, the prison gulag industrial complex? Should they invest in Microsoft, the copyright terrorist? It's sad. But I hear what you're saying, and I can't say it's a bad idea, because ultimately you have to think of your family's survival. So if it means putting a few extra dollars to work, I mean, if Al-Qaeda could go public on the New York Stock Exchange and give people in America the same way to make money in Al-Qaeda that Obama does, that Cheney does, that Donald Rumsfeld does, I think that would be a lot fairer.
That's right. Well, Al-Qaeda's only for them to do insider trading, to start wars and stuff.
That's right.
But
why can't they do Al-Qaeda an offering on the New York Stock Exchange? You know, the symbol could be AQ.
Well, wait a minute. They did. They did 7 years ago. They came out with a trading thing on terrorism.
Yeah, the policy analysis market based on my technology. And they, John Poindexter introduced it. They quickly shut it down. But they do it now, insiders. I'm saying they need to make that available to the public and allow people to invest directly into Al-Qaeda, since they're now employing Al-Qaeda to kill people in Syria. I mean, Americans need the opportunity to make the same amount of profits on Al-Qaeda that Rumsfeld and Obama and Cheney and Biden are doing. I mean, that's only fair.
You know, that's what's so insane about all of this, Max, is that I study this 18 hours a day, as I know you do. And it's so crazy, I can't even believe it at this point. And it only gets crazier each day. I appreciate your call, Mike. We're going to come back and take more calls here. My phone just went crazy and just answered and just went nuts. My phone was just sitting here, and it just picked up and went to some kind of crazy. Wasn't even touching it. My phone has just gone. My phone has just gone completely insane. Guys, will you take my phone out of the room, please? Thank you. I'm going to try to reset my thought and find out. That was bizarre. It's like the announcement that they're going to have government-forced announcements over your phones, NSA two-way. I'm going to try to come back, and I'm talking about how the world's gotten so bizarre and crazy, I can't even deal with it anymore. My phone just starts, like, making like I was on the top of a mountain or something. It's like, I'm sure it's just a glitch. Let me reset there and come back with Max Keiser to try to ask that question again. And go to Jay, Kathy, Brendan, Paul, and many others. Toll free number to join us, 800-259-9231. Welcome to Planet Crazy. And I'm super bad. Monday through Friday, we're here, folks. Weekdays, 12 noon to 3 p.m. Eastern. We have InfoWars Nightly News, 7 o'clock every evening. As we went to break, I was trying to get the question out to Max Keiser before we go back to your calls. He joins us now from the U.K. I am a great financial and geopolitical analyst, in my view, that I study this stuff. I don't want to exaggerate. I don't work as hard as I used to, maybe 16 hours a day. Some days I work 20 hours a day, but on average about 16 hours a day. And I know I'm telling the truth. I know I'm very accurate. I know, as crazy as this show sounds, that unfortunately I'm overall telling the truth. I'm trying to tell the truth. I try to disprove what I'm saying, and it just gets crazier and crazier. So I look out into the future. Yes, the technocrats have the NSA spying and have all the economic insider data. And yes, they've got these militaries. And yes, they've got. But I talk to the military. Most of them are waking up. I talk to the public. They're waking up. Confidence in newspapers is an all-time record lows. Confidence in Obama, all-time lows. 17 points lost last month by under 30s. I mean, he's just imploding. Congress, lowest approval rating of 10% ever. I've seen one of 9, but Salon and others and Breitbart say it's 10. Gallup says that's the lowest ever. So there's some positive things, but it's kind of like Greece or Spain or Mexico. You know the government's corrupt, but it just kind of settles into the police wear a black mask, you're a slave, sewage runs down the street. And then up on the hill and palaces, the rich people live up there. And so is there a way to extricate ourselves from this madness? Because I mean, things are getting crazy so much faster. It's almost like a quickening or a singularity of corruption, Max. Do you see a light at the end of the tunnel, a way to get out of this? And if we don't, how do you see it ending?
Well, I thought it was very interesting, referring back to the Edward Snowden comments today, when asked about encryption, he said that encryption does work. Encryption does keep the snoops at bay. And immediately it got me, you know, thinking again about Bitcoin, which is a cryptocurrency. It's a completely encrypted currency. And I really believe that this is going to help us get to the promised land by having an economy outside of the Wall Street's ability to corrupt it. And that doesn't say that Bitcoin can't be used in levered products. I'm sure at some point it will. But the underlying source code of Bitcoin is incorruptible thanks to the genius of its creation, which I think is going to go down in history as one of the most ingenious inventions ever, right there with the light bulb and a few other ingenious inventions. And so I think that Bitcoin came at the right time. It's a path to salvation, not to put too rosy a glow on it. And we had confirmation today from Edward Snowden that encryption does work. It is a powerful force against government intrusion.
Well, what it makes them do is have to spend more time cracking it. And so we shouldn't just make it easy for them, and we shouldn't use Facebook. We shouldn't use Twitter. I use it, but as a way to jack in and fight the system. But as a general public, Google, all of it, whatever you can do using a proxy like startpage.com, whatever you can do to not make it easy on them is key. My problem is we run advertising. And the last three companies that we've used to run our advertising software get bought by Google. So, Max, what do you do when the monopoly just buys everything up? I think that goes back to the last caller saying, what do you do when they own the whole economy and it's impossible to even operate outside of their system? That's what Monsanto and all of them admit they're going for.
Yeah, I admit that that's a growing problem because the money used to buy up all the assets is gifted to them through 0% interest rates. And that's one of the problems of having 0% interest rates. It leads to what are called malinvestments. They're malinvestments for society at large. It's great if you're an insider and a kleptocrat. But if you're somebody who's not, it really has to be classified as a malinvestment. But we are, as I point out in my article for InfoWars Today, exclusive, I might add, there is also crowdfunding, which is interesting because you are bypassing the usual routes of money raising. A lot of interesting projects are now being financed using crowdfunding platforms, which are outside of the machinations of Wall Street. So I think that's another alternative economic model that's rising. If you combine the two with Bitcoin and crowdfunding, which is something that's an interesting combination, I think that would be a powerful force. I mean, it requires a lot of out-of-the-box thinking, a lot of technologically aware thinking, and I just don't want to throw in the towel and say that we're all going to be living in this NSA pre-crime bubble of casino gulagism. I mean, I have to hold out some hope that ingenuity and people like Edward Snowden, in my mind, and Glenn Greenwald, I mean, this is what America has produced. It produced at least two people that are embodied the spirit of the founding fathers. There's at least two, Edward Snowden and Glenn Greenwald. So at least we have two people carrying the torch of America 238 years later. Maybe they'll get to a place where they can start to beat back and force down these interlocutors.
I don't want to hog you anymore. I want to go to these phone calls for you, but you were mentioning at the end of the last hour how McDonald's made a deal, and there's a lawsuit over this, with one of the big private central banks to put their money only in that account and then charge them money to be able to look at their money or get money out, which is a form of total slavery. And that's out of the Philadelphia Daily News. But here's another one. Sesame Street says P is for prison, and that's okay. And then during the break, I was going and reading the transcript of the shows, the new Sesame Street shows. It teaches the kids how to become prisoners and how that's their future and how to drink and have guns and all this stuff. I mean, everything is a primer. I saw a few months ago where in New Mexico and other states, they have whatever Wackenhut's new name is, I forget the exact headline, in there as school security, priming the kids for prison, and you have deals with the states saying, we promise to put this many people in prison, you know, if you'll move to our state. I mean, it's incredible. We have a bigger prison population than anybody in the world.
Well, you're referring to Corrections Corps of America. They made a deal with several states, several municipalities, where they will take over the cost of running the prisons for those states if the state guarantees 98% occupancy. Of course, the only way the state can guarantee that is if they just make a lot of arrests and throw a lot of people in prison, regardless of any due process. But that was okay for many states in America and many municipalities.
It's just amazing. They're engineering the economy into this predatory system, and no wonder a lot of cops walk around and act like goons. That's who they want. That's who they're hiring. Let's go to Jay. He wants to talk about the big sign of the crash. Jay, you're on the air with Max Keiser.
Hey, gentlemen. Real pleasure to speak with you. Hey, listen, being as that I believe we're just about at the end, the Constitution is literally hanging by a thread. My question is, what is the sign financially, at least for you guys, that's going to say, you know what, that's it, I'm packing up, I'm heading out?
Well, I've decided to go down with the ship. I'm taking 100% of the profits that come in here, 100%, and putting them, I mean, I haven't paid myself in a long time, into trying to build this operation in the face of it. I have hope. I believe we can turn the tide. Look at how many people are waking up. And I have hope, what Max just said, that people in the system are going to show some more courage. Because I'm here to tell you, folks, your kids out there have no future if so many yuppies and businessmen and smart people think they're safe on the sidelines. Think again. Max Keiser, what's the sign for you that the implosion is about to accelerate?
Well, two signs. I mean, as we talked about,
yeah, sorry, Max, your phone cut out. Go ahead and say that again. Okay, we're going to have to reconnect with Max Keiser. Jay, I appreciate your call. I'm going to try to get his point on that. Look, the Pentagon admits now they're gearing up for economic disaster. We had an article last week that Drudge Report linked to where Homeland Security DHS is buying all this riot gear and putting them in pre-placed caches all over the country. And then you say, hey, it looks like the derivatives are going to implode and there's no way to pay them back. It's not our debt. You're gearing up for martial law. Here's your training manual. Your enemies, the Tea Party? Your enemies, gun owners? Veterans? Really? And they're like, yeah. So we have Max back. His phone degraded. What are the signs again, Max Keiser?
Yeah, hopefully you can hear me. Just a couple of things. One is interest rates. As they go up, that's a sign not of growth but of bond panic, as I've been saying for a few months. And then you saw a story last week, 10,000 people lined up in China at a shop to buy gold. So even though gold has been trending down in price, it hasn't scared people out of gold. It has encouraged thousands, tens of thousands of people in China and other and elsewhere outside of the American echo chamber to be buying physical gold. That's a huge sign. That should tell you volumes about where this thing is going.
Absolutely. We're going to go to break and come back with the final segment with Max Keiser. I'll try to go to your calls quickly for Kathy and Brendan and Paul have been holding the longest, and I'll get to everybody else after that break and get to stacks of news that's broke since I got on air, plus all the rest of the news. MaxKeiser.com is his website. You can follow him, Max Keiser, at Twitter. You can follow us at The Real Alex Jones on Twitter. Very important to sign up there because I send a lot of alerts out and things. I don't really use email, but I do use Twitter, especially at night and on the weekends. So please follow us at The Real Alex Jones. And please send out an email to your friends and family and retweet that you can see the free video feed of the show as well at Infowars.com/show and find all the free iPhone and Android apps and podcasts right there.
You're the devil in disguise.
Is a little devil. Real quick question, number one, right to these calls, Max Keiser. Do you expect the Federal Reserve to start tapering, giving themselves unlimited free cash? I mean, the markets are acting like they believe that's happening. Or will they continue the pumping?
They will definitely continue until there's a bond crash.
So why are the markets going down in anticipation of a tapering?
Because the Federal Reserve likes to play the market, and they trade on inside information. They tell people beforehand, Bernanke tells people, okay, I'm going to talk about tapering, and everyone plays a piggyback that trade. And then he'll come back and say, oh, no, I spoke too soon, and then everyone piggybacks that trade.
Exactly. So it's milking the schmucks.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, absolutely. I did it myself many, many times. It's just exactly what a stockbroker does to milk their clients, but done on a multi-trillion dollar level. This is exactly the same game any broker does with their clients. They scare them into selling and then get their greed up to buy. It's just the same exact thing, but a multi-trillion dollar
version. Unbelievable. Kathy, you're on the air. Thanks for holding. Go ahead.
Hi, Alex. Hello, Max. I'm from South Carolina, and the reason I'm calling today is because we had a tuberculosis outbreak in a county here in South Carolina, and patient A was medically detained by the Department of Health and Environmental Control. Apparently, there was a new law in 2011 that allows them to do that.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Let people in from all over the world with leprosy and TB, but then once they get here and spread it, they're going to lock you up, yeah.
Yeah,
you have a question for Max on that? Max, you want to comment on that, medical tyranny?
Not really. I mean, it's not really in my area of specialty, but it sounds bad.
Yeah. Kathy, what do you think about it?
Well, it's kind of disturbing to me because I think it sets a precedent for just detaining somebody when they say that, okay, well, you have an illness, and now we're going to detain you for 30 days.
It's very, very dangerous, absolutely. There's some reasonable reasons for quarantine, so something like Ebola or something, but they're definitely using medical tyranny as an excuse to push things that are far more dangerous. Here's one. Saudi Arabia announces 4 new deaths from MERS virus. Let's take another call here. Let's talk to Brendan. You're on the air with Max Keiser. What's your question?
Hi, Max and Alex. Some of my patrons at my business have become fans of MaxKeiser.com and Infowars.com by trying to disprove what I've told them in the past. However, some devotees of Paul Krugman and CNBC and others are eager to tell me, I told you so, regarding the price of gold. And I wondered if Max could give a nutshell explanation on how the price is basically at the same price that it costs to extract the gold from the ground and give a little assurance to those friends of mine who actually...
Well, I mean, I'll say this. They can manipulate gold all day. They're on record doing it. They can manipulate the value of gold down for a while, but they're only building a paper bubble. I haven't sold any gold I've bought. And just tell them, believe in the system, and just go down with the ship. Max Keiser.
Well, the supply of bonds has never been higher in America's 238-year history. Bonds have never, the supply has never been higher, and the yield up until a few weeks ago has never been lower. The bond market's in a massive bubble. Gold, on the other hand, the demand has never been higher, a physical demand, never been higher around the world, a physical demand, and the price has pulled in from the high of 1900 back to the...
Yeah, there are articles bemoaning that the Chinese and Indians and Americans won't sell their gold because there's the real market and then there's the paper market.
Right, so but Paul Krugman is an academic like Ben Bernanke, and he'll tell you on paper why this is this way and this is that way, but the people in China lining up 10,000 strong to buy gold don't read his white papers. They just see an economy coming to ruin, and they're protecting themselves, and eventually they will overcome this physical barrier.
That's right.
That is the artificial price suppression. But the problem is that the price can very easily jump quite dramatically to above the $2,000 level, and then if you're not prepared, you will have the satisfaction of believing Paul Krugman's wrong ideological claptrap for 6 months, but having any gold.
Folks, read his exclusive article for Infowars.com. Keiser, the collapse of the current bankster regime is upon us. It could be true. Max, I'm drafting you. I know your girlfriend, your betrothed is there, and you guys want to go to dinner, but do 3 more minutes on the other side. I want you to expand on where you think this collapse is going and talk about gold briefly. Then I'll let you take one more call from Paul, who wants to ask you who controls the world. Then massive news blitz and more calls. We're going in, through, and beyond. I'm Alex Jones, and this is The InfoWar. All right, Max Keiser's our guest for a few more minutes. Then I'm going to cover a ton of news and go back to your phone calls. And believe me, there is a ton of important news, so please stay with us here today. Max, in closing, I bought gold when it was $300 an ounce, didn't sell it when it went up to, you know, almost $2,000. I bought silver when it was $5 an ounce, didn't sell it when it went right up to $50. And if you look at the 12, 15-year charts, it's only going straight up. But I don't have gold and silver as a investment, even though it's been a pretty good investment the last decade, one of the best. I have it as an emergency backup because we've never been awash in so many giant inflationary bubbles. Where do you see gold really going? And in layman's terms, how are they been driving it downward?
Well, first of all, in terms of gold, the alternative would be government-issued paper. And have we heard anything in the last 2 months, 3 months, 6 months that would give you more confidence in the government? Does the NSA spying scandal and the PRISM scandal give you more confidence in the government? No, it gives me less confidence. So I don't want to be in a government-issued piece of paper, the U.S. dollar or any other fiat currency. That means that leaves only gold, silver, and Bitcoin. I put in the same category. Now, the number of ounces that I own has not changed. Whether the price is 1,900 or 1,500, I have the exact same number of ounces. And going forward, that's the key. It's not the price, but ounces, and at some point, grams. If you have the same number of ounces and grams, you have some protection against these lunatics. The price is not really the most important thing to consider. Paul Krugman is a guy who defends the status quo. The New York Times, who he writes for, defends the government, and they want more government spending, more government control. That just is not going to work. It didn't work for Stalin. It didn't work for Pol Pot. It's not going to work for Barack Obama. More government control is not going to work. I'm sorry.
Well, you're certainly right about that, and at the same time, you're saying you believe this is the beginning of the bond market imploding. You notice the bond market's been going up and up and up because that's all people think is good. And you said a year ago, that's the sign. How high will the U.S. bond market go, the Treasury market?
Okay, the last bond collapse we've had was 1994. Interest rates went from 6 to 8%, and bonds lost between 20, 25, 26% of their value. Here we're talking about interest rates going from 2% to 4, 5, and 6%. So doubling or tripling from where they've been. That means that the bond prices won't lose 20 or 25% of their value. The bond prices will lose 50, 60, 70% of their value. That means that all banks are insolvent. That means the government has to come back and print, as we said, $100 trillion to bail them out.
And I know the Fed has made noise about
$10,000 an ounce.
So the Fed has made noise, the private Federal Reserve that calls itself federal, the foreign bank that has a fake name, a camouflage name, the invader bank says they're going to raise interest rates probably next year, and at the same time they're going to keep, though you think, giving themselves...
Well, they say they might raise, they might not raise, they might taper. That's just all trading gimmickry for trade on inside information. While they're screwing around, the bond market all by itself, completely out of control, will collapse. And interest rates will go from 2 to 5 to 6%. That will just be a collapse, just like people who might be on the edge of a you know, a fault line will play a game as to whether or not the earthquake will hit, and they'll try to profit from it. But once the earthquake hits, there's nobody around the earthquake that's going to be able to control it. It's just out of control. And once these interest rates hit that critical mass, people, banks, we're going to see one of these major banks is going to come out and say we're bankrupt because interest rate. We already saw this happening in Japan. Japan is already on the critical list. We're seeing banks now reporting stress because interest rates are creeping higher. Their balance sheets are imploding. They'll come out and they'll print more money. Maybe they can stave it off for another month or two.
And that point, parallels. And that parallels with decadence and corruption. I mean, anytime societies get degenerate and lose touch with reality, things implode. And I, unfortunately, Max, we're going to have some interesting times ahead. Thanks for spending so much time with us. Let's get that one final call from Paul in New Jersey. Paul, ask your question of Max Keiser.
Yeah, I wanted to ask him who controls the world and all. Well, I more or less know who does, but...
Well, since you know, Paul, tell us.
Well, it's the big banks and the esoteric societies. They've been doing it for years. We haven't had a constitutional government since the Civil War. When we went into martial law, then came the Federal Reserve and the Communist Manifesto, and they locked it in 1933 and set up the U.S. Corporation in 1935 after the bankruptcy and set aside our Constitution.
You're right. It's esoteric societies, basically think tanks that study how to manipulate humanity and create new scams, who then lobby to dumb the public down so that we can never rival them and actually try to be free. Max Keiser, do you agree with that statement?
Well, I would just add that now you have the addition of computer programs that do all the heavy lifting and go out there and do a lot of this dirty work for them.
Yeah, thank you, Paul. Max, that's a final question there. From what I've been told by people with the NSA who, over the years, you know, literally, I don't go to them, they come to me and just pop up, but their info has turned out to be very accurate. And when I say NSA, contractor groups associated with it, the holy grail for 20 years has been to get enough data to be able to predict mass movement in the future, and they've now got that. And with that, they can actually manipulate the future. And so we have these control freaks manipulating our future. It's a worst-case scenario. I mean, from your inside info, is that basically what the NSA is about? People say, oh, jam it talking about terrorism. From all we know, it's not about that. It's about rigging the world economy and rigging the human culture.
Right. The human psyche is a lot more predictable than people want to admit. And if you give the government the power to play on that obvious predictive ability, where human nature tends to react very consistently under certain conditions, you're giving away the power to be free. I mean, this is what we're talking about. But the prism is a prison.
The only group not in control of themselves is Jamie Dimon and Don Corzine making 50-1 bets. I mean, isn't that the paradox here, is that the people running things are not in control of themselves?
Well, it's hard to understand the motivation. You know, Jamie Dimon has kids. You know, his daughter now writes for some fancy magazine. The world that he's left her is quite appalling, and he should be ashamed of himself.
Yeah, I mean, what about your children? I used to always hear this as a youth and go, kids, who cares about them? And now that I have them, that's all I think about is how do I make the world better? And people laugh at me. Oh, you're a square. You don't know how to get ahead. And they're just idiots. Isn't that the biggest con game in the world? Is thinking that you're not, you know, that you're going to spoil things and not have it come back on you?
It's just the delusionary behavior that comes with omnipotence and unlimited power and no government checks or balances. There's no law. There's no deterrent. Anyone will go psychotic if you give them unlimited access to cash and no law and no deterrent. Just about anyone would start acting out in a bizarre, heinous, omnipotent, godlike way.
I wouldn't. I'm not like that.
Most people would. You know, if you give the average person $1 billion and say you can do anything you want, there's no laws. And anytime you lose any of it, we'll just give you more. And most people would go crazy. And they'll just start acting very godlike.
No, that's what history shows. Exactly. Absolutely. Wow. Max Keiser, thank you so much. I look forward to you being back with us. And thanks for writing an exclusive article for InfoWars.com.
Okay, great, Alex. Glad you enjoyed it. Speak to you soon.
Yeah, tell Stacey Herbert, thanks for letting us have you longer.
Will do.
There he goes. Yeah, she's in the background. She had dinner ready for him 30 minutes ago. I heard him in the background. Honey, come on. It's hot. The dinner table's set. That is quite a couple right there. Nice folks. I tell you what, they look a lot alike. In person, meeting them, it's really strange. They even say the same thing. They have the same little pug noses, and they look the same. It's very, very interesting. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. Wow. No exaggeration. I've got like 50 articles I've got to at least mention. Briefly, I want to just add a couple things here for everybody out there. And it's basically this. We are a listener-supported broadcast, and everything I do here on air, things I promote are things I believe in. That's A. B, these tools will help wake up your friends and family and others. And by voting with your dollars, we're going to really be able to change the world. So I promote things I have looked into, I've studied, that I really think are excellent. And we also offer very, very low prices and good deals. And so it's important to shop with the good guys. This is a free will universe if we have our way. And it's up to you to support us, spread the word about the broadcast, you name it. The entire system is attacking us and demonizing us every day because they know we're growing and they know that we understand their game plan. And so that's why it's important now more than ever to support Infowars.com, to get a nightly news membership, a PrisonPlanet.tv membership. We make it so easy. It takes about a minute to sign up. You get 11 memberships on the same username and passcode. So you create a unique username passcode that you can share, give it to 11 friends or family or even more, and 11 people can be logged in simultaneously with the same username and passcode, prisonplanet.tv or infowarsnews.com. If you already have a membership and haven't been sharing it, give it to friends and family. Say, here's your free, you know, news site subscription. This is really powerful info. Wake people up. That's how we're going to win this fight. And it's happening. The president has the lowest approval rating ever. The Congress has the lowest approval rating ever. The mainstream media has the lowest approval rating ever. They've figured out that you and I and millions of people in the U.S., it's billions worldwide, are discrediting them, are stabbing them. And I want to go on stabbing them. And I'm not trying to be in on the air to become an aristocrat. You know, they say every revolutionary is a closet aristocrat. Many philosophers have said that. I think that's bull. I really want to build a better world. I really want to go to space. I really want to empower the individual and empower our greatest people to flourish. It is the ultimate sin, in my view, of the establishment trying to dumb people down to control them and poison them culturally, but also chemically and biologically to manage them. I mean, it is really a cold-blooded move. And then I look at the globalists themselves, a bunch of hunchback, crazy-looking old men, you know, who just drip evil. I mean, more BBC people indicted and arrested. Another one. I mean, I see this all the time. BBC ex-broadcaster sentenced for sex assaults of 9-year-old girls, 14 counts, pled guilty. Folks, David Icke said that this guy was a child molester many years ago, and I did stuff like delay him out on air and stuff. David Icke, by the way, worked there, and he says it's basically all pedophiles at the top. And prime ministers slitting kids' throats and all this stuff. And you hear this stuff a decade ago, and you're like, man, I'm not going to have David Icke back on. And then it turns out it's true. I mean, no wonder he was around this and heard about it. I mean, you can't blame him thinking they're blood-drinking lizards. Maybe that's easier to believe. I mean, you know, I mean, they might as well be. It's blood-drinking lizard or not, he's not saying they're blood-drinking lizards. The point is, I don't even know. This is just one article. I mean, who are these people? Anyway, side issue. There's a new film I'm in, I consulted on, and I like it so much, I am the exclusive distributor of this film for the first 90 days of its release. We've got it on Blu-ray and DVD, and you can get it on Blu-ray or DVD, State of Mind, the History of Mind Control, the present and the future, to really get people to understand the admissions of this so they understand there's a warrant for their mind. And I'm doing this. We might want to add up there at the top of the special that every order of State of Mind gets a free citizen rule book and InfoWars bumper sticker, but more importantly, you get a American Dream film absolutely free. And I see it hidden there in the fine print. We might want to add there on the site that and in the banners that you get a new film, and then you get the 35-minute or so animated documentary that's so entertaining and really made for the general public to wake them up to the Federal Reserve really being a Rothschild, Rockefeller offshore crime syndicate. So again, ladies and gentlemen, I want to encourage everybody, go to InfoWarsStore.com and get State of Mind, the Psychology of Control. And with it, you get the American Dream free while supplies last. And it's not like you order and then don't get it. The computer knows how many of these we have, and as soon as it's sold out, it'll disappear off the screen that it's available. But we've got less than 5,000 of these, and it will go quick. This is a new major release. And it's voiced over by the lady that plays the replicant, the main in Blade Runner, and a bunch of other stuff. It's just got a lot of amazing people in it. So State of Mind, The Psychology of Control. Available exclusively at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. And don't forget, we have the very best health and vitamins and minerals and wellness products at InfoWarsTeam.com. You can also sign up there as a distributor and get discounts at InfoWarsTeam.com. And you can also go to InfoWarsHealth.com. Or if you have any questions, you can call 888-789-9277, 888-789-9277. That's for InfoWars Team, 888-789-9277. Or you can simply go to InfoWarsHealth.com, a mirror site as well. Well, I'm running out of time, and I said I'd go to these callers. Wesley and Eric and Charlene and Corey and others. And I've got all this news as well. What are we going to do here? It really becomes overwhelming at a certain point. Where to start here? Where to start? You know what I'm going to do? I'll take a call now. I'm going to go to break, come back, cover the news, and then go into overdrive with calls. But I've got to get to this news, I promise to, and there's so much of it. And then it almost becomes a kaleidoscope of info. Wesley in Oklahoma, you're on the air. Go ahead. Thank you for holding.
Hey, Alex.
Hey, buddy.
I'm friends with James Lane, actually. I do his hair, and I'm telling everyone else they do need to buy State of Mind, History of Mind Control off of InfoWars. I'm also a Prisonplanet subscriber. Enough of that. I know you get that too much. What I called for was something I haven't heard you mention is onion routing, or it's called a Tor, and it's a type of software you can download that will encrypt all of your data. It directs your internet traffic through a volunteer network, and it keeps people from surveilling or analyzing what you're doing online. It makes everything more difficult to trace because everyone else running a Tor client is bouncing what you're searching online.
We've talked about that some. You know, my whole issue is even above trying to avoid all the surveillance that's illegal, by the way, how about we take our government back and stop this? I mean, they say they're doing it for terrorists. They run the terrorist. The elephant is in the room. They're mainly using this to spy on the economy to have unfair trade advantage. I appreciate your call. Maybe you can do my hair. Maybe you can shave my head. That's how I get my hair done. We'll be right back. Stay with us. All right, let's run through a bunch of the news here. Edward Snowden says Google, Facebook misleading their users about how much of their data goes to the NSA. No kidding. I've interviewed the telecom whistleblowers. It's in the Telecommunications Act. Everything is run through and stored. They're just incrementally introducing you to this. Here's another article. Obamacare will share personal health info with federal state agencies. You see, that's always been the plan. So those articles are out of, both these articles are out of the Washington Examiner. Maybe we can have a document cam shot on that, and I'll show the TV viewers right down here. So again, Obamacare will share personal health info with federal and state agencies. Of course they do. Report, school districts scan children's eyes for bus program without permission. Of course they do. It's all about the state taking over your kids. It's like Obama having a gay and lesbian event and having, you know, young children introduce it. It's inappropriate. Whether it was a thing about heterosexual thing, it's just always shoving sex in everybody's face and training everybody, your kids are ours. Flashback, Obama launches total takeover of media system. I cover that because now it's being announced that your cell phones will have text and coming up video break-ins. Even when it's off, the government will force its way in. State photo ID databases becomes troves for police for the face scanning camera databases. You see how that works? Told you years ago that's what it was for. It was in the executive order. That's in my first film made in 1997. And now it's being used. In that same executive order, it says they're going to take blood at checkpoints, but they're without warrants, but they're priming the pump right now with checkpoints and the cops going, "Mind if I have some blood?" And every person goes, "Oh, you know," the cop said, "stab your child." The mother go, "ha, ha, ha." Just whatever they're told, you know, just worshiping government. It's all Stockholm syndrome. Athens man spends 10 hours in cell for refusing to give DNA. They're just taking DNA for everybody, even if you're arrested for bubblegum, you know, throwing bubblegum on the sidewalk. That's just some of the news on that front. But just keep pushing, crooks, because your approval ratings are dropping. Everybody hates you. Everybody knows who you are, okay? Keep calling me a kook and a liar and a nutball. Everybody knows you're liars. That just sends everybody here. Supreme Court rules Arizona cannot require voters to prove U.S. citizenship. Incredible. Don't have to even show an ID, ladies and gentlemen, because, again, they're going to bring in groups of people that are clients of the government to vote to take our guns. So there you go. There's that very important information. That's just some of the news we have on that front. Continuing here, Google's launching internet balloons. They're really NSA balloons. That's their cover for that. Putin says West arming Syrian rebels who eat human flesh. That's Reuters. And they go on in the article admit, well, they do eat human flesh. We, of course, broke those articles about a month ago. France's News 24 reports Saudi Arabia wants missiles for Syrian rebels. I predicted this would happen about 3 months ago. I said they'll have the Saudis come out, because they always use them as the surrogate, and say, oh, we need to transfer missiles to them to shoot down aircraft so that there's not a discussion of where they really got them. And that is from NATO out of Libya, which we know they did. That way, when Al-Qaeda shoots down U.S. airliners, they'll say Saudi Arabia gave it to them, and then we'll invade some other country. Oh, Saudi Arabia gave them the missiles? Well, we'll invade Russia then. Like, oh, Saudi Arabia, the hijackers came from there? Well, we'll invade their enemy, Iraq. How's that? That's right. Blow them Arabs up. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. That's just some of the news. And then I've got the shutdown of U.S. producing an abysmally low number of primary care doctors. The plan is bankrupt healthcare, then fully nationalize it. So their goal of bankrupting America is going right on schedule. The Detroitization of the Republic. Nightly news tonight, 7 o'clock. 7 o'clock Central tonight. PrisonPlanet.tv.
Visit GCNLive.com to
Texas, Alex Jones.
The nanny state could care less about composting. You can bet when he's staying in $5,000 a night hotels like Michelle Obama stays in $3,000 ones, they're not composting. Nanny Mike strikes again, plans to force citizens to compost. That's an excuse to dig through your trash and fine you. They've already done it in Europe. That's up on Infowars.com right now. Speaking of bankrupting America, $3,300 per room a night for Obama and his entourage. That's per room. And Obama assassination bid fears aircraft carriers on standby off Irish coast during G8 summit. Aircraft carriers to make it look like this puppet actually runs something. These presidents are puppets, ladies and gentlemen. Speaking of this, and I'll get a few calls in, the Gateway Pundit reported on this yesterday, so we talked about it. AT&T to load iPhones with emergency alerts from Obama that you can't switch off. And I told you this years ago, and here's one of our cruise phones, T-Mobile, Verizon, you name it. It's not just the NSA that's spying on you. The government now will send you messages even when your phone's off. It will turn on. Because the Fuhrer, Kim Jong-un, I mean Obama, is telling you. And again, they prime it with stuff like, oh, Amber Alert, little girl's missing. Or, oh, a flash flood warning this area until 10:30 p.m. Oh, what would you do? Nanny state. Messages to you, everyone. This is so they can flash up people who they want to pick up in the future and stuff. Imagine what Hitler would have done with this system. Let's jam in some calls. Thanks for holding. Charlene. I call this my rifle, Charlene. That's from Full Metal Jacket. In Pennsylvania, you're on the air.
I was just wanted to report that Bachman, Gormit, and Steve King are having a rally, which they can't call a rally, for open discussion on to stand up against amnesty. It's now called a press news conference.
Good.
It's the Capitol steps and on Wednesday.
Well, everybody should be there. This is to bankrupt the country and to drive down wages, and it will not help the third world countries. And the globalists are rubbing their hands together, saying they're going to let the illegals vote and take our guns. And then they plan to have a civil war, which is all planned as well. I mean, again, if most of the illegals weren't programmed for socialism and programmed to dislike any the good parts of this country, the globalists wouldn't be letting them in. They want this because it is the coup de grace against this republic, Charlene.
I agree, and they're asking for anybody that's in the area to come there. It might last all day, because this is going to be the longest news conference they ever had.
Yeah, maybe we should send one of our reporters there who's on the East Coast, because this is the type of stuff we need to be covering, and I should have gotten into the amnesty thing more today. It's just like, you know, the herbicide in the water, getting everybody breast cancer and everything else, and this is just a bunch of, look, it's craziness. The globalists just love to kill people and control things, and they make excuses of why they're doing it. Thank you, Charlene. Corey, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hello, Alex. I've got a plan to exponentially increase your listenership. I went to Start Page. I got a printout of the Alex Jones radio station PDF file. I found out locally here it's KIDO out of Boise. Anyway, I made a 2x3 sign that says Out of the Loop. Find out now. Tune in to 580 KIDO. At the same time, you're on in the local area, 5 to 8 p.m. here locally. You stand at your busiest intersection. You could change the sign every day or two to say, honk if you're listening to Alex Jones on 580 KIDO or whatever. People have nothing better to do while they're driving to or from work to check out your program.
No, exactly. RM and FMs are such treasures, and everybody out there needs to tell friends and family every day when the show's on. If I'm on a station, you better believe they're going to have other good shows on as well. And if people would just go out and tell people to tune in with a sandwich board, it would change the world. God bless you, Corey. Thanks for holding. I'm sorry to Tom and Marcus and Victor. If you call me back tomorrow, I'll get to you. I apologize. I've got to go. I've got too much to do. The nightly news coming up tonight. A bunch of other stuff happening. More breaking news continually at InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.tv. Great job to the crew and great job to the listeners out there.